In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a CMS-driven web page in EditorX that dynamically displays your web design portfolio items. Let's go. Hey everybody, welcome to Creative X. My name is Brad Hussey and I'm a web designer. This video is the second of our portfolio series where I'm walking you step by step through building a beautiful and dynamic portfolio website for your web design business using the power of EditorX. In our last video, we created our site styles library, built our homepage, and set up our masters. So that's our header, our pre-footer, and our footer. And now we're gonna set up our dynamic portfolio index page. Let's do that. Okay, so let's review our Figma design file and then make a plan. So we're gonna be building this here, the portfolio index. It looks pretty simple, but there's actually gonna be a lot happening in the background here. So we have our alternating layout with each portfolio item, with our image on the side, text on the right, with our button, and then it alternates like so. So what we're gonna do is we're going to utilize a feature in EditorX called repeaters. And so a repeater is simply a feature in EditorX that allows us to create a series of elements that repeat the same design and layout. So we create it once and it repeats as many times as we want. Now the trick is to dynamically pull the information in so that we're not just adding the items manually. We want them to dynamically pull that information in from a database. And we can do that in EditorX. And the other challenge here is that a repeater will by default have the design match identically. So the images will be on the left, the text will be on the right for every item. We want that to alternate. So we're actually going to get a little bit creative to make that happen dynamically using Velo dev mode. And I'll show you how all of that works. So in our portfolio page here, let's add an element. We're going to quick add a repeater. We're going to change that to list, stretch that to fill the space. And now within here, we actually just want to make the minimum height 500 pixels for each item. Drag a container within the repeater, stretch it, apply a grid at 2:1, so it's 50-50. Select the section, and we're going to give 10% padding on the left and right to match the design. Now I want to add the image on the left side, so I'm going to add in the media library here. I'm going to upload the images from my starter files. Go ahead and do that, drag it in. I'm going to select an image, add it to the page, and then I want to attach it to the left cell of this repeater, stretch it to fill. Now I want to quick add a title, a paragraph, and a button from our portfolio site assets. Align that, put it in a stack, space everything out nicely. And I want it to be centered vertically and horizontally within this right cell. So just doing that now. Now we're gonna add those lines, quick add some assets here, align, drag it in. We're gonna match the design. It's gonna be 1 pixel line width. We're gonna choose a line color that's very light gray. We're gonna duplicate this item as well and drag it to the bottom. I wanna put all of these elements in a stack as well so I can fine tune the spacing between each item. And now I want to make this fill the cell 100%, but we need space in between the image and the text. So I'm actually gonna change the grid layout, go to advanced mode, and then I'm gonna add a gap in between here. So I'm gonna say 5%. And that looks pretty good. We'll preview this and see what we've got so far. Now I wanna add a little bit of spacing in between these repeater items on the vertical axis. So I'm just gonna select the repeater and I can actually change the vertical margins here. They're set to 4 pixels. I'm gonna make it 5% to match everything else. That looks good. And now let's preview this and see what this looks like. Okay, looks good. Let's check it out in the Figma design to see how we're looking. I can see that there's a background, it's a slight gray here. So let's actually change that while we're here in EditorX. It's gonna select the page itself in my layers panel and change the color to the FAFAFA hex code. Perfect. Now we've got some white backgrounds in the repeaters and the items. I'm just gonna remove those by simply selecting the items themselves and making the background just fully transparent. And now we're starting to look a little bit better. Preview that. Yep, that's looking better. All right, so it looks like these lines need to be at the top and the bottom of these containers. So I'm actually going to unstack this whole thing here select the line and the bottom one, I'm gonna dock it to the bottom with zero margin, make sure it's aligned properly. Select the top, I'm going to dock that to the top and fix the alignment, that looks better. And just align this stack here with the text. Just make sure that this image here is in fact stretched to fill the container. You can stretch it manually or you can select the stretch icon in the top right-hand corner just to make sure. All right. And we'll give this a quick preview. This is looking pretty good so far. I'm happy. All right, at this point, things are looking really good so far, but the content is static, which simply means what we've built in EditorX so far is what we see on the front end. We're not pulling any information from a database, and that's exactly what we wanna do. So what we're gonna do next is we're gonna create a database with our portfolio items in the database so that we can pull all of the latest entries from that database and display it on the page. Yes, you can do that in EditorX, and I'm gonna show you how right now. So now we need to add our content manager. So we can do that by clicking on content manager up here in EditorX, turn on the content manager, and then here you have some options. You can add presets, create collections, manage your content, and so on and so forth. We're gonna create a collection. And what we wanna do is we wanna name this collection. So this allows us to store and manage content to use anywhere on the site. So we're just gonna call this portfolio items. How many items do you want to have in your collection? So there's multiple items or a single item. We want to have multiple items. So manage multiple pages or repeaters with the same layout like projects or service listings. Exactly, create. So now we have our content manager here with our portfolio items. And you can see this is basically going to be like a spreadsheet. And that's all a database is. It's basically a spreadsheet that contains data with different organization of that information for us to use dynamically on our site. So we need to go ahead and create a spreadsheet that will contain the information from our portfolio items. So if we review our Figma design file, it looks like we have portfolio title, portfolio summary, URL, and image. So let's add that information now. So now we have our data architecture. What we want to do is add an item. And here I'm simply just adding the title, summary, URL, and image from each item that's found in the design. And this is how we can add more portfolio items moving forward. So I'm just doing that right now. Okay, so I have our data set here with each of my portfolio items. Now that I've got that stored in there, we are going to come back to this and use this. Okay, so now I'm going to select our repeater here. And you can actually see there's a new icon here in our little pop-up called Connect to Data. And that's because we now have a data set that we can connect data from. So I'm going to select that. And it's going to ask to connect our repeater to our template here. So start by creating a data set. Let's do that. We're going to choose a collection, portfolio items, and the data set name is just whatever you want to call it, portfolio items repeater. Now what we could do is associate each element on the template with the data that we created in our content manager. So for the image source connects to the image in the database for this specific data set, okay? And then alt text, if you wanted to do SEO, you can actually put a summary here if you want, or just put a title. You can do tooltips as well. You can do links. We can also link that to the URL. So if you click on the image, it will go to the URL that we set. Now let's go back. Now let's select our text. The text is going to connect to the summary. Actually, the text is going to select the title. And then this other text element is going to be connected to our summary. And then finally, our button, the click action is going to open the URL. And the label, we're not going to connect. We're just going to have it be whatever it says in the design, which is view project. So let's preview this. All right, we've got our first portfolio item, our second portfolio item, third portfolio item, and our fourth portfolio item, all dynamically added via the content manager. And if we add new items, it will display here in our repeater. Now we're left with one more challenge. This layout does not match the design, which is alternating. Now, there are probably a number of ways to do that, but I'm going to show you one of the ways that I learned how to do this to make it alternate. And that's going to be through a little bit of creative thinking. And then we're also going to use Velo developer mode to write just a little bit of JavaScript. So the first thing we're going to do is turn on dev mode. That's going to switch our UI a little bit so that we see a code editor, which I'm going to minimize. And in our layers, we see IDs rather than page names. And that is what we're going to use to manipulate the layout of the page. So how do we alternate these layouts? Well, what we're going to do is actually take our repeater here, and we can see that we have each repeater has an item. And then within there, we have our image on the left, right here, and our text on the right. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to take this container and we're going to name it even container. And then we're going to duplicate that and call this odd container. And I'm going to make sure that that's stretched to fill. So now we have two containers, even and odd. What we're going to do is hide the odd container for this moment. And we're going to adjust the layout of the even container. So I'm going to select the image. So I've got the image selected in our even container, and I'm going to change it to be in the right cell. And then I'm going to select the container with our information about the portfolio and move it to the left grid cell. Okay. So now our even container looks like this, and our odd container is the alternate. So both are there, it's just the odd container is sitting on top of the even container. So what we're actually going to do now is in our dev mode in Velo, we're going to look for every odd item or every even item rather, and we're going to toggle which container we're displaying, the odd or even container. I want to select our repeater. In our repeater, both our odd and even container. Right here, you can see different properties and values for each of these elements. We actually want to have our default values for both of these containers to be collapsed. So default values are the element's state when the page loads. So collapsed just means we don't want it to appear on the screen. So collapsed. Even container, collapsed. So now let's open this up. We're going to maximize this. And within these parentheses, we're going to load the repeater layout function, and that function is going to look like this. We're going to select repeater one and on item ready. So this is once this item appears on the page. Now we're going to check for even and odd indexes with an if statement. And that condition will be if index, so the number, modulo 2. So do a little bit of math, is exactly equal to 0. So that will tell us that it is in fact an even number. We will then say item. We're going to select even container, and then we're going to actually expand it. So it used to be collapsed. Now it will be expanded if we have an even number. And then we're going to do the reverse for the else. Simply make it an odd container will expand. And now, if we've done our code right, if I preview this, we'll have an alternating layout with dynamically generated portfolio items coming from our content manager. Beautiful. All right, our EditorX portfolio site is coming along nicely, but we still got a ways to go. So what we're going to do next is create a dynamic page for each individual portfolio item so that we can display more context and more information for each of those portfolio items. So if you want to see that video, tap the like button, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss it. And I want to invite you right now to our CreativeX crew. It's our brand new free community for web professionals like you who are building amazing things for the internet. So links are in the description below. I'll see you in there, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.